Hello everyone, today we'll be talking about cataracts. So cataracts is a medical condition in which the lens of the eye becomes progressively opaque, resulting in blurred vision. Cataract is by far the commonest cause of preventable blindness in the world with an effective surgical treatment. In the UK, approximately 250,000 cataract operations are performed each year, making it the commonest surgical procedure. Etiology. Age-related opacification of the lens is the commonest cause of visual impairment, with 30% of people over 65 years having visual acuities below that required for driving, Snellen acuity less than 6 over 12. The common causes of cataracts are summarized in the table below. So etiological classification, I don't know if it's very clear though, I'm going to go through it so you can understand. So they divided 1, congenital or developmental. Then we've got senile, complicated, such as uveitis, high myopia, retinitis, pigmentosa, retinal detachment, glaucoma, ocular ischemia, metabolic, traumatic, radiational, dermatogenic, maternal infections, toxic, cataract associated with systemic diseases. So this is a simpler table which we're going to go through. So congenital causes are maternal infection, familial, age, common in the elderly, metabolic, diabetes, galactosemia, hypocalcemia, Wilson's disease, drug-induced corticosteroids, phenothiazines, meiotics, amiodarone, traumatic, post-intraocular surgery, inflammatory causes are uveitis, disease associated is Down syndrome, dystrophia myotonica, Lois syndrome. In young patients, familial or congenital causes should be excluded. Any history of ocular inflammation is noted. Cataracts diagnosed in infants demand urgent referral to the ophthalmologist in order to minimize the subsequent development of amblyopia. So, morphological classification of cataracts. There are 6 main types: capsular, subcapsular, nuclear, cortical, lamellar, which is congenital, sutural. It's very common and it's congenital. So the Y-shaped opacities within lens nucleus, and there's no clinical significance. So in this lecture, I would like to focus more on senile cataracts as they're so common. Age-related cataract is by far the most common variety, occurring bilaterally, often asymmetrically, in persons above 60 years of age. Both males and females are equally affected. Senile cataract is familial and shows a strong hereditary tendency, manifesting at an early age in successive generations. So, types of senile cataracts. So, senile cataract occurs in 3 forms: 1, cortical; 2, posterior subcapsular; and nuclear. Clinical features of senile cataracts. In the initial stage of cataract, almost all patients remain symptom-free. Common symptoms of cataract include glare, black spot before eyes, distortion of objects, polyopia, colored halos, and a variable degree of visual impairment. Glare or dazzling is common under bright light conditions. The patient feels handicapped in night driving because the posterior subcapsular opacities obscure the pupillary aperture when miosis is induced by the bright light. Black spots may be perceived by the patient due to the presence of lenticular opacities. Distortion of objects occurs in the early stage of cataract formation due to changes in the refractive indices of the lens fiber causing irregular refraction. Polyopia occurs due to an irregular refraction, and the patients often complain of seeing many moons in the sky or perceive many images of an object. Colored halos may be seen by some patients due to the hydration of lens fiber. Impairment of vision is variable depending on the site, extent, and progress of the lens opacity. Early cortical cataract does not cause any impairment of vision, while mature cortical cataract and posterior polar cataract lead to marked visual loss. The patients with immature cortical cataract can see better in daylight, but feel handicapped in twilight or interpupillary dilatation. Conversely, the patients with nuclear cataract have better vision in dim light. Second sight develops in patients of nuclear sclerosis. Difficulty in near walk occurs in old age due to loss of accommodation. In patients with lenticular sclerosis, index myopia develops, leading to deterioration of distant vision But the patient starts seeing better for the near and may even give up the use of presbyopic glasses, a phenomenon known as second sight. So what's the pathophysiology of cataracts? The pathophysiology behind senile cataract is complex and yet to be fully understood. In all probability, its pathogenesis is multifactorial, involving complex interactions between various physiologic processes modulated by environmental, genetic, nutritional, and systemic factors. As the lens ages, its weight and thickness increases, while its accommodative power decreases. As the new cortical layers are added in a concentric pattern, the central nucleus is compressed and hardened in a process called nuclear sclerosis. So one of the causes that we've come across is nuclear sclerosis. Multiple mechanisms contribute to the progressive loss of transparency of the lens. The lens epithelium is believed to undergo age-related changes, particularly a decrease in lens epithelial cell density and an aberrant differentiation of lens fiber cells. Although the epithelium of cataractous lenses experiences a low rate of apoptotic death, which is unlikely to cause a significant decrease in cell density, the accumulation of small-scale epithelial losses may consequently result in an alteration of lens fiber formation and homeostasis, ultimately leading to loss of lens transparency. Furthermore, as the lens ages, a reduction in the rate at which water and perhaps water-soluble low molecular weight metabolites can enter the cells of the lens nucleus via the epithelium and cortex occurs, with a subsequent decrease in the rate of transport of water, nutrients, and antioxidants. Consequently, progressive oxidative damage to the lens with aging takes place, leading to senile cataract development. Various studies showing an increase in products of oxidation, e.g. oxidized glutathione, and a decrease in antioxidant vitamins and the enzyme superoxide dismutase underscore the important role of oxidative processes in cataractogenesis. Clinical features: gradual painless deterioration of vision is the commonest symptom. Other symptoms are dependent upon the type of cataract. For example, a posterior capsular type would lead to glare and problems with night driving. Early changes in the lens are correctable by spectacles, but eventually the opacification needs surgical intervention. So what are the investigations that you do? The blood glucose, serum, calcium, and liver biochemistry should be measured to diagnose metabolic disorders that may have led to cataract formation. As you may have recognized that we mentioned some metabolic disorders that may be the cause of cataract formation. So what's the treatment? Treatment is small incision extracapsular or phacoemulsification. Cataract extraction with the insertion of an intraocular lens is the treatment of choice. So that's all about cataracts. If you like the video, please like, subscribe, and comment. Thank you.